Katherine, how are you?
I'm very well, thanks.
Thank you so much for your time. I need to start saying thank you because I just realized that you work in pretty much all my favorite movies. It's like since E.T., Indiana, The Goonies, Back to the Future, all the Jurassic Parks, and now it's Star Wars. So yeah. How do you feel to be part of this?
Oh, it's been exhilarating. I mean, I feel like 3 years has gone by since I stepped into the company, mm-hmm. and it seems like yesterday.
And how do you feel the evolution of technology since, let's say, your first movie, E.T., until now?
Well, you know, it's interesting. It was amazing when we decided to do all the creature effects in Episode 7 mm-hmm. as real animatronic characters, much like we had done with E.T. Mm-hmm. With E.T., we had a lot of puppeteering, we had a lot of cables. Now what's happened is the robotics have become so sophisticated mm-hmm. that I was pretty amazed at what they were doing. And all the skin textures, very, very realistic.
So I can feel that it's like going back to the practical thing. It's, mm-hmm. it's like because CGI in some moment is like too much, and now it's like going back to the traditional practical thing. So do you think this movie start a new era of that?
It might. You know, I've always been a big believer that it's using the entire toolbox, mm-hmm. that you want to try to use as many different techniques as there are available. And then you look at where the techniques can actually benefit the storytelling. Mm-hmm. And one of the reasons we wanted to do things as practically as possible is if an actor is in the room interacting with one of the robots or interacting with one of the creatures, it's nice to have them in the room to just put that in front of a blue screen. It creates some sort of artificial distance yeah. in a way. And I think the audience recognizes and understands when they are actually yeah. looking at something real.
It's the feeling of realism.
Yeah.
Sometimes a guy in a suit is much better than a CGI
yeah,
creature,
it's
right?
true.
And so it's great that JJ decided to do the real thing. So how amazing was being on the set with big scale of the sets and all that?
Well, I think the minute we walked onto the set and saw the Millennium Falcon full size, yeah. that pretty much took everybody's breath away. Mm-hmm. So it was great.
I read also that the security was super extreme, that the actors only got the page of the day and the main screen was surrounded with cameras and policemen and all that. So is that true?
Yes, it is true. I mean, we did everything we could mm-hmm. to try to protect things, but at the same time, we asked people to be a part of behaving in a trustworthy way and not spoiling it for other people. I think that's one of the things that's been really important to us, is recognizing that the fans, and the fans are us as well, nobody wants to walk into the theater and feel like the most important part of the plot has already been talked about and exposed and seen. And so we're trying to keep it a surprise for everybody.
Yes. Like I am your father sequence. Like,
yes.
You know, everybody is like...
Yeah, it would have been terrible if everybody knew that before yeah. they went to
There's
the
There's no
movie.
Social media at that time, so it was yeah. very easy to keep the secret. So what's the plan of the plans with Lucasfilm in the future?
Well, we're looking at a lot of different things that we're doing. In the film area, we're starting to do Star Wars stories, which mm-hmm. we began shooting Rogue One, which started this summer. Uh-huh. Mexico's own Diego Luna is
yes.
in that movie.
Uh-huh.
And we'll finish that December 18th. And then we begin the next episode of the Saga series, which will be Episode 8. And we start that January 23rd with Rian Johnson directing. So it's been extremely busy. We also have 3 episodes of Rebels uh-huh. on television right now. And we've got all sorts of things happening with the theme parks.
Yes,
at Disney.
Bob Iger announced
yeah.
that I was there at the team.
Yeah, that's very, very exciting.
And you also, as a producer, took part of that creative...
Oh, yes, as president of Lucasfilm, I get involved in all of those conversations, whether it's a game, the parks, the movies, animation, television, all of that.
I can imagine your agenda must be great. When you open your email, it's like 200...
Yes, I have to stay on top of it.
Wow.
That's true.
So, and with Indiana Jones?
Indiana Jones is something I'm talking to Steven about right now.
Uh-huh.
He's doing a movie in the spring, but we'll start talking about story, I would say, in the next couple of months, and then hopefully we can start to look at when we can make that movie.
For me, my love of cinema is because of 2 movies, Star Wars, of course, and Indiana Jones. I was 10 years old.
That's all because of George Lucas.
Exactly.
Pretty amazing, huh?
It's like when I saw the Temple of Doom, it's like, blow my mind, so thank you for that.
Thank you.
And that's, if you can define each of the directors with one word, right? One word for Steven, one word for George, and one word for JJ.
Oh, wow. You know, an interesting thing about the three of them is that they love movies. They always make emotional stories with wonderful characters that people can relate to. And they all have a sense of hope in their stories. I would say that that's consistent amongst all three of them.
The positive thing.
Positive. Very optimistic people.
In your career, can we expect, because you got a lot of experience in production, so maybe direction in some moment?
You know, I thought of that many years ago, not now. Mm-hmm. I'm too busy, I'm very happy with what I'm doing, and in order to go off and direct something would require me to go into the tunnel, as we say in the business, and I just don't think that that's something I want to do now. But I have huge respect for directors. I love working with directors, understanding what their vision is, supporting that, providing the resources for that. So that I guess that's the closest I get to directing.
Do you like to see your own movies? Is it like that something that you enjoy? Is the movie's done and move to the next?
I do pretty much move on. I don't necessarily revisit them. But if I'm looking on television and one of my movies shows up again, sometimes I'll settle in and watch a bit of it. I love showing it to my kids.
Of course.
You know, that's fun, is to introduce them to some of the movies I've made.
And tell all the, you know, behind the scenes.
Yeah.
That's so cool.
Yeah.
So how important is now the social media and the technology for the movie business?
Oh, it's huge. I think social media and how it's played a role in the marketing of this movie, for instance, has been a real learning experience and very, very powerful, especially internationally.
And that also could be like, you know, you need to plan every single post and all that. It's like, you got like a digital marketing team?
We have a digital marketing team inside the Walt Disney Company and at Lucasfilm. And it's something that we talk a lot about because every little thing we do explodes internationally. Yeah. So you need to be more thoughtful, I think. The other thing that I think is, It's a little tricky, is that certain places in the world don't know Star Wars as much as others. And that's been a bit of a challenge, because when you want to go into those parts of the world and perhaps spend more time educating, show more, talk more, you can't really do that because it ends up online.
Yeah.
So that's been something that we've had, you know, we've had to talk a lot about.
I remember when Bob Iger announced the part was huge explosion, of course, but he didn't tell when. So can you tell us when?
Well, we're starting bits and pieces of it in the next year, and some of it, the exhibition aspects of what we're going to do are starting at Disneyland now, and then the actual Star Wars land, that's a few years away. But all of that planning has been going on in the last couple of years.
Will be in this new era of Star Wars,
I suppose.
In this,
like, yes, but it's not attempting to try to follow along with exactly what the movie is.
Okay.
It's really exploring the whole universe of Star Wars.
To finish, now it's a huge fan base of pretty much everything. You hear, I'm fan of that. Or when you're growing up, remember which kind of things attract your imagination or something that you could say, I'm a fan of that when you're growing up?
Inside the Star Wars universe?
No, in general.
When you're
a kid, when you're a teenager, you say, okay, I'm a fan of, I like that.
You know, it's interesting. I don't remember being caught up in the level of fandom that exists today. I mean, certainly when I got interested in making movies, I became a real fan of certain filmmakers and whatnot. But I don't think the level of things that exist today with the way everybody sort of galvanizes around a certain movie or a certain character. And I didn't read comic books as a child. It's funny, I hate to say it, I don't think a lot of girls ended up reading comic books. Today, if I was 10 years old, I'd probably be reading comic books and paying more attention, but that didn't necessarily become a part of the culture for little girls then. I'm glad that's changing.
Yes. Well, thank you so much, Gardena. Thank you for all your amazing work. Thank you for the inspiration. And
thank
please
you.
Keep going, and hope to see you soon again.
Thank you. Pleasure. Good to meet you.